God is good all the time. Put a song of praise in this heart of mine.
Morning, church, and all viewers.
God is good.
Today's scripture reading is taken from Psalm 47, verse 1 to 9. To the chief musician, a psalm of the sons of Korah. O clap your hands, all you peoples. Shout to God with the voice of triumph. For the Lord Most High is awesome. He is a great king over all the earth. He will subdue the people under us and the nation under our feet. He will choose our inheritance for us, the excellence of Jacob, whom he loved. God has gone up with a shout, the Lord with the sound of a trumpet. Sing praises to God, sing praises. Sing praises to our King, sing praises. For God is the King of all the earth. Sing praises with understanding. God reign over the nation. God sit on his holy throne. The princes of the people have gathered together, the people of the God of Abraham. For the shield of the earth belong to God. He is greatly exalted. May the Lord bless the reading of his word. Amen.
All the time, through the darkest night.
Good morning, viewers. The title of my exhortation for today is Live by Faith in the Presence of God. Faith is more than just believing. It is taking our very own lives on what we believe. Faith in God means that we are willing to follow God's guideline for living as an outline in the Bible, because we have the conviction that this is the best for us. In 2 Corinthians chapter 5 verse 7 says, walk by faith, not by sight. There are few ways we can learn how to live by faith in the presence of God. The first is step of faith. We must believe in the promise that we cannot see. God promises to those who follow Him, though you don't be able to see proof of those promises with your own eyes, but you must believe that God keeps His promises as an act of faith rather than one of sight. In John chapter 3 verse 17 and 18 says, for God did not send His Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through Him might be saved. By the condemning of His Son, he who believes in Him is not condemned, but he who does not believe is condemned already, because he has not believed in the name of the only begotten Son. This simply means that accepting Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior and as the Son of God will lead you to salvation, as is stated in Matthew chapter 16 verse 17. For the Son of Man will come in the glory of His Father with His angels, and then He will reward each according to his works. If we live by faith, not by sight, you will receive the salvation promised to the believers as followers of Christ. Number two, let go of your fear. Fear is real and fear is normal, but it can paralyze us. Fear can distort your view of reality. It makes the giant in your path appear more than powerful than your Almighty God. The world can be a frightening place, and sometimes you may do things out of fear that contradicts God's will. If you want to walk by faith, you need to release your fear and then turn your fear to God. Accept the path He may lead you. You may not be able to become completely fearless, but you can be courageous and learn to act according to God's will, even you are afraid of what lies ahead. In Isaiah chapter 41 verse 10 says, "Fear not, for I am with you. Be not be dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you. Yes, I will help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand." And verse 13, "But the very hairs of your head are all numbered. Do not fear, therefore. You are of more value than sparrows." Number 3, focus on things that have eternal significance. Finances and possessions, these things disappear along with the mortal body and have no spiritual value. A big house, a fancy car, are things the world might value, but they won't matter much in God's kingdom. Earthly success is not inherently evil. You can live a comfortable life in a nice home with a good job and still walk by faith, but sometimes the problem is prioritizing the symbols of earthly success over of spiritual things. We have to focus on unseen realities like Jesus and heaven. Center your life around these realities instead of the visible temporary realities of your own earthly life. Be thankful of our earthly blessings. However, store up treasures in heaven by doing the will of God as instructed in Matthew chapter 6, verse 19 to 21. "Do not lay up for yourselves treasures on earth, where there are moths and rats destroy, and where thieves break in and steal. But lay up yourselves treasure in heaven, where neither moth nor rust destroy, and where thieves do not break in and steal. For where your treasure is, there your heart will be also." Number 4, obey the Bible to know God's command. Living your life of your faith in God's will requires you to follow God's law above the ways of men. God's law can be learned and understood through the study of His Word, which is the Bible. Meditate His Word day and night and put into action. Faith without work is dead. Understand that there are times when the world will try to convince you that something forbidden by God's law is acceptable. You cannot control the actions of those around you, but as far as your own life is concerned, you must live accordingly to what God has deemed is right and just. And number 5, glorify God in all you do. Do everything for the glory of God. 1 Corinthians chapter 31, 1 Corinthians chapter 10 verse 31 says, "Therefore, whatever you eat or drink, or whatever you do, do it all for the glory of God." Giving glory to God and being fully persuaded that what He has promised, He is able to perform. To give glory to God is to reckon God to be what He is and to rely upon His power and faithfulness. we also glorify God by our worship. Worship ascribes all glory to God alone, and we can glorify Him in many ways. But Scripture indicates that nothing we do delights God more than calling on His name with sincere hearts and declaring that all glory belongs to Him. And lastly, 1 Peter chapter 1 verse 7, when your faith remains strong, through many trials, it will bring much praise and honor and glory on the day when Jesus Christ is revealed to the whole world. Amen. Thank you, everyone. Stay safe in God's presence. God bless.
God will shine. God is good. God is good.
Good morning, church, and to all viewers, happy Mother's Day. Today, the topic for exhortation will be discovering God's way in a changing world. The world, as you see today, church, is going through a major shift of change. Things have really changed overnight due to the outbreak of COVID-19. Even though the world is changing, but God's word is unchanging, and so are His ways. There are three things we can do to discover God's ways. Number one, be still and know that He is God. It's in Matthew 24, verse 35. Heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will not pass away. We now have more free time to spend with the Father, so we must seize this opportunity. Matthew 6 verse 6, but when you pray, go into your room, close the door and pray to your Father who is unseen. Then your Father who sees what is done in secret will reward you. Despite what we hear from the media on the spread of COVID-19 all over the world, we must turn to scriptures for faith and comfort. Through our prayers, God will rewarded. As in Psalm 91 verses 1 to 16, he who dwells in the shelter of the Most High will abide in the shadow of the Almighty. I will say to the Lord, my refuge and my fortress, my God, in whom I trust. For he will deliver you from the snare of the fowler and from the deadly pestilence. He will cover you with his pinions, and under his wings you will find refuge. His faithfulness is a shield and a buckler. You will not fear the terror of the night, nor the arrows that fly by the day. As we quieten ourselves in prayer, in the presence of the Almighty, we will surely find assurance and peace in our hearts. Because God is with us, and He will definitely protect us. However, at the same time, we must also exercise practical wisdom to keep safe. As in Psalm 139, verses 23 to 24, search me, O God, and know my heart. Test me and know my anxious thoughts. See if there's any offensive way in me and lead me to the way everlasting. As we put our trust in the Lord, He will put His thoughts in us, and God will lead us into a path of peace, and a time of refreshing will come. James 4 verse 8, draw near to God, and He will draw near to you. God's word and God's promises are unchanging and have authority over this changing world. As in Joshua 1 verse 8, the book of the law shall not depart from your mouth, but you shall meditate on it day and night, so that you may be careful to do according to all that is written in it, that you will make your way prosperous. Then you will have success. Through meditation and confession of God's word, we shall have our way prosperous and good success. Number two, cleansing the inner man, which is the temple of the Holy Spirit. God wants to use us as His vessel, but first He must cleanse our hearts. This is God's way. As in 2 Corinthians 6 verse 17 to 18, therefore come out from them and be separate, says the Lord. Touch no unclean thing, and I will receive you, and I will be a father unto you. and you will be my sons and daughters, says the Lord Almighty. As in Deuteronomy 14 verse 2, you have been set apart as holy to the Lord your God, and he has chosen you from all the nations of the earth to be his own special own treasure. As in 2 Corinthians 7 verse 1, since we have these promises delivered, let us cleanse ourselves from every defilement of body and spirit, bringing holiness into completion in the fear of God. In Galatians 5 verse 16 to 26, but I say, walk by the Spirit, and you will not gratify the desires of the flesh. For the desires of the flesh are against the Spirit, and the desires of the Spirit are against the flesh. For these are opposed to each other, to keep you from doing the things you want to do. But if you are led by the Spirit, you are not under this law. So therefore, let us serve God in faith and in good conscience. In 1 Timothy 1 verse 19, holding on to faith and having a good conscience. In Hebrews 9 verse 14, how much more will the blood of Christ, who through the eternal Spirit offered himself without blemish to God, cleanse your conscience from dead works to serve the living God? Point number 3, arise and shine in his name. After we have drawn near to God and learned to rest in him, allow the Lord to cleanse our hearts, we must now move forward. We must arise and shine in his name and experience blessings and victories in our life and be a testimony for him. Isaiah 60 verse 1, rise, shine, for your light has come, and the glory of the Lord rises upon you. John 5, 3. Then Jesus said to him, get up, pick up your mat and walk. John 16, 33. I say these things to you, that in me you may have peace. In the world you will have tribulation, but take heart, I have overcome the world. Philippians 4, 19. And my God will supply every need of yours according to his riches in glory, Christ Jesus. Therefore, we must rise and shine, following Jesus, and not to go back to our own selfish and worldly ways. As we see in John 21 verse 16, after these things, Jesus showed himself again to the disciples at the Sea of Tiberias, and in this way, he showed himself Simon Peter, Thomas called the twin Nathanael of Cana in Galilee, the sons of Zebedee, and two others of his disciples were together. Simon Peter said to them, I am going fishing. They said to him, we are going also with you. They went out and immediately got onto the boat. And that night they caught nothing. But when the morning had come, Jesus stood by the shore. And yet the disciples didn't know that it was Jesus. Then Jesus said to them, children, have you not any food? They answered him, no. Then he said to them, cast the net to the right side of the boat and you will find some. So they cast, and now they were not able to draw it in because the multitude of fish were so in abundance. So the disciples went back to their old ways as fishermen, and they are disappointed. However, when they follow the instructions of Jesus, they are richly blessed. So in conclusion, let's not go back to our old ways, but learn to follow God's way in changing this world. His ways are not our ways, but they are higher, and they are found. Isaiah 55 verse 8 to 9. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, nor are your ways my ways, says the Lord. For as the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts. Hope you are blessed by this exhortation, church. Stay safe.
God is good all the time. He put a song of praise in this
morning, church, and all viewers. The title of my exaltation is Hope in God. What is hope? Hope is commonly used to mean wish. But in the Bible, hope is a confident expectation of what God has promised and in his faithfulness. Faith is substance of our hope. Hebrews 11 verse 1 says, now faith is confident in what we hope for and assurance about what we do not see. Faith in God's love, His word, and power give us hope for every day. I want to share 3 points about hope in God. Number one, God is God of hope. Romans 15 verse 13 says, God is God of hope. This means He is the source of all hope. If we are going to have hope, it must come from God, for He alone has the power to give us. Jeremiah 31 verse 3 says, I have loved you with an everlasting love. With unfailing love, I have drawn you to myself. Nothing in this world can compare with God's love for us and His power in our lives. God is love, and He loves us unconditionally. Isaiah 41 verse 10 says, Don't be afraid, for I am with you. Don't be discouraged, for I am your God. I will strengthen you and help you. I will hold you up with my victorious right hand. As we meditate in the incredible attributes of God in the scripture, it gives us great hope and confidence for our life. Example of God attributes. God is faithful, immutable, almighty, trustworthy, loving, all-powerful, all-knowing, wholly compassionate, righteous, and more. Hope depends on knowing God and resting in His grace. Let's look at a few scriptures in Bible about hope. Psalm 71 verse 5 says, For you are my hope, O Lord. You are my trust from my youth. Psalm 146 verse 5 says, Happy is he who has a God of Jacob for his help, whose hope is in the Lord his God. Psalm 46 verse 1 says, God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Point number 2. Hope in God's promises. Hebrews 4 verse 12 says, The word of God is alive and powerful, sharper than any double-edged sword. God's word has the ability to change the way we see ourselves and even our future. Hope comes from believing the truths and the promise of God in His word. Hope strengthens our heart and holds us to our faith in God's promises. Hebrews 6 verse 19 says, Hope is the anchor of the soul. Our soul is our mind, our will, and our emotions. As we fill our mind with what God says about us and claim His promises as our own, it will bring hope and build our faith. We can't always change everything that is happening around us, but God's words will change us, how we think, how we feel, and how we view our circumstances. God's promises in His word gives hope for many things. Examples, Psalm 42 verse 11 says, Hope in the Lord's unfailing love gives peace, security, and rest to the soul. God gives us peace, joy, and rest as He hopes in His unfailing love. Psalm 42 verse 5 to 7 says, Patiently wait for God alone, my soul, for He is the one who gives me hope. He alone is my protector and deliverer. He is my refuge. I will not be shaken. God delivers me and exalts me. God is my strong protector and my shelter. Psalm 31 verse 24 says, Be strong and let your heart take courage, all you who hope in the Lord. Hope gives us strength, courage, and boldness. Hebrews 10 verse 23 says, Let us hold fast to the confession of our hope without wavering, for He who promised is faithful. God is faithful to keep His promises. Point number 3. Abounding hope by Holy Spirit. Hope releases the power of the Holy Spirit in our life. Romans 15 verse 13 says, Now the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace in believing, that ye may abound in hope through the power of the Holy Ghost. God of hope will flood our soul with exceedingly overflowing joy and peace by the power of the Holy Spirit in us. Holy Spirit is the power of God, who produces in us His fruit of joy and peace as we trust in Him, so that we abound in hope every day. Hope also enables us to endure hardship and long waiting periods, and God uses this time to develop character and endurance in us through His Holy Spirit. Hope builds us up as we wait on God. Holy Spirit is our comforter and helper. He will guide us, give us grace and strength to get up and move forward. He will lead you one step at a time into the fruitful life God has planned for us. Jeremiah 29 verse 11 says, "For I know the plan I have for you, declares the Lord. Plan to prosper you and not to harm you. Plan to give you hope and a future." God promises to prosper us and give hope and bright future. Romans 12 verse 12 to 13 says, "Rejoicing in hope, patient in tribulation, continuing steadfastly in prayer, distributing to the needs of the saints, given to hospitality." In conclusion, whatever we may be facing or experiencing in our life right now, we can stay hopeful because God of hope is with us. Seek God, who is the source of all hope, and let us put hope in Christ our Lord and Savior. Amen. Hope you are encouraged with my exhortation today. Take care and God bless you.